Hello and welcome to this training video on setting up and performing an ADS-B Autotest in accordance with AC20-165B and CS-ACNS requirements using the AVX-10K Flightline Test Set from VIAIV Solutions. In this video, we will be talking about setup and preferences, determining test type, GPS position, advanced settings, running the test, and saving the test. After turning on your test set, open the transponder ribbon and select the ADS-B Auto application. All tests on the AVX-10K have a set of common preferences that need to be set before testing. Our video Common Test Settings and General Preferences goes into greater detail. Once you have gone through the common setup parameters, enter the barometric altitude reference. First, enable the barometric altitude setting by selecting Yes. Select No if using geometric input versus barometric input. Then, enter the test altitude, typically field elevation for surface testing or as simulated by the pitot-static test set. Caution: ensure that appropriate precautions are taken to avoid transmission of the aircraft's position when testing above field elevation by using antenna couplers and testing indoors. There are two selections for test type. AC20-165. Is the ADS-B test requirement defined by the FAA's 14 CFR 91-227. And CS-ACNS is defined by EASA, EU Regulation Number 1207-2011. The regulations are very similar, with the CS-ACNS version requiring a few additional ADS-B out parameters. Choose AC-2165 for the Americas. All other locations use the EASA CS-ACNS test requirements with desired aircraft separation of 3 or 5 nautical miles. The next setting is the GPS position setting. This provides users with two options for setting the GPS test reference location. First, user entry allows users to manually enter the latitude and longitude via the touchscreen. Or, if you have access to the open sky, choose GPSRX, and the AVX-10K internal GPS receiver will automatically set the location. Once you have a 3D fix, select Save Position Reference to transfer the latitude and longitude as your test reference GPS position. Note, please ensure that the latitude and longitude position captured is as close as possible to the aircraft under test active GPS antenna. It is recommended to use a known or surveyed location to compare against the aircraft's reported GPS position for best results. The advanced settings are not changed often or may be specific to the testing environment. The Check All UUT Capability option should be set to Yes. The ADS-B Auto DF setting should be set to the type of ADS-B system installed. DF-17 is used for 1090ES transponder-based emitters, while DF-18 is reserved for non-transponder-based beacons like those used in ground vehicles and on obstacles. The position decode option has two choices, global and local. Typically, this is always set to global, which ensures both odd and even position squiders are used to determine your location and best represents the actual position determination. The local option uses only one position squider, plus the latitude and longitude entered to help determine the aircraft's reported position. Setting Verify Unit Setup Configuration to Yes tells the AVX-10K to display a pop-up window after hitting the Run Test button and prior to running the test to verify setup parameters. The Recall Data button allows users to recall and populate the data of a previously performed test for review. Previously saved tests can be selected to review the data in the ADS-B Auto instrument. Now that the setup is complete, choose either the airborne or surface test, depending on how the aircraft is configured. In this example, the airborne test is performed first, but both tests will need to be run to get a complete test. Press Run to start the test. The data is collected from the aircraft squiders, as shown here. Once all registers are populated, a pass-fail indication will be shown. The test continues to monitor the aircraft's squiders and compare against the referenced altitude, latitude, and longitude until the stop key is pressed. The pass-fail criteria are based on reported NIC values and register content in the squiders being transmitted. The operator then chooses the surface tab to complete the ADS-B auto test. The aircraft must be configured in the ground condition before the operator presses the run key to start the data collection. The surface test takes slightly longer than the airborne test because the squitter interval is considerably longer. The testing result will show as incomplete until all of the required squitters are received. The data is then populated for review. Although heading shows as NA, the AVX-10K will disregard this parameter if the ground speed is stopped, because many GPS receivers will not provide a heading if the aircraft is not moving. Pressing the Save Data key saves all of the test data for the airborne and surface tests on one report. The data can then be transferred to a memory stick or uploaded to StrataSync. See our video on using StrataSync with your AVX-10K video for more information. Send your questions or comments to americas.service@viaivsolutions.com or call 1-800-835-2350.